and I'll praise. It's shifting, shifting the eyes.
To what they have done. I am the Alpha and the Omega, the first and the last, the beginning and the end. Blessed are those who wash their robes, that they may have the right to the fruit, to the tree of life, and may go through the gates into the city. I read to you Revelation 22.
We have our prayer, my sister Cynthia. Amen.
Thank you for the new year we are going into, Lord. We pray
that
you just
go
to our hearts,
minds. Welcome, amen.
Divine temple of God, I want to welcome everybody to the new year, 2013. We want y'all to continue to keep coming and have a blessed year. Amen.
Divine temple of God, Christ.
Thank you.
Yeah. sure he's a
flame.
I know that he is a evil. So much wickedness. So many people have turned their hearts from God. We've seen people killing each other, family members killing each other, husbands going in and killing the entire family, wives killing the children, and so on and so forth. A man sat down saying he carved the back of his son's back in a pentagram saying that it was to mark a holy day. I mean, the world, the hearts of men is waxing colder and colder. And I mean, just riding down the street, you're just riding down the street, this road race, just riding down the plain streets, not even on the highway, you just riding down Belford and people are having road rage. There was a lady that, her and another car had gotten into an accident or something, met him at the gas station, she ended up shooting the man. The world is getting evil and evil. And if we don't keep our minds and our hearts on God, the word said for 2012, if you don't possess, God was giving everybody an opportunity to take advantage of what God has for you. He was saying, possess the land. It was time to move on into the land. Possess it. Take what God has for you. Or if you don't, when you get into that land, you will be possessed. And the enemy is possessing people. When people saying things that they're doing, people are saying, oh, these people just went crazy. No, they didn't go. These people are possessed. They are possessed. And we have an opportunity to either possess the land or to get possessed. The word says that there will be a great falling away. And we've seen a great falling away. We're looking at it now. Usually when we used to come for a night watch on for the New Year's, it used to be packed. And I was really expecting for it to be packed on the night, but you know, it's like, well, it's a lot of people probably had other agendas or they were looking at the rain or whatever, but nothing was going to stop me from bringing in the new year with God's people. Because, you know, we always, when we were in the world, it was said, you know, whatever you went into the new year doing is what you're going to be doing for the rest of the year. So I just made it my thing that every year I'm going to go into the new year praising the Lord, going to the new year serving God, going to the new year gathering with the saints of God, because that's what I'm going to be doing all year long. Many of us in our lives and in our journey and where how we've been or where we are so far in God, a lot of us have felt like we were going in circles. You know, it feels like, you know, seem like if I get two steps forward or I take one step forward, it ends up I take four or five steps backwards. It just seems like I'm going back and repeating the same thing over and over. It seems like, how am I ever going to get out of this cycle? How am I ever going to break this tree? How am I ever going to stop this? But when we're looking at this text today, God was telling the people, he said, we turned, he said, because these people had came from out of, they were getting ready to go into the new land. He said, when you get ready to go into the new land, you're going to pass through Esau's land. And we know that Esau represents the flesh. So you're going to be in the world. A lot of us have worldly jobs because this is how we have to make it in the world. The Bible says that money answers all things. So in other words, it's not saying that money is my main thing, but in order for me to survive in this land, because we have to obey the laws of the land, and this is how it goes, it takes money. The Bible says that if a person don't, if you don't work, you don't eat. So we have to work in order to maintain. So we're going to be going through Esau's land. He was telling us, in order for us to get into our promised land, to get into the thing that God has for us, you're going to have to dwell or be amongst Esau for a while. But he says, don't intermeddle with him. Just go and buy and do whatever you have to do to survive. Because I have blessed the work of your hands. He says in verse 7, I have blessed the work of your hands. And if a lot of you look back over your life, think back at the things that have happened in your life. Some days, I know you probably wondered, how did I ever make it? There were many times that I had to rob Peter to pay Paul. Because my change was strange. My money was funny. I didn't know how I was going to make it. There were bills that was coming in. And I'm like, oh, I don't want this to be turned off, but God, I'm going to still trust you. And see, and even he says in the word of God, don't intermeddle with them. Don't become a part of them. So I can be in the world, but not be of the world. I'm going to survive in this world, but what we have to do is make sure that the world can see us and see God in us. Because we are supposed to be lights. He said, let your light shine before men so they will see your good works and they'll give glory to God. So while we're in the land, we got to continue to trust in God. We got to continue to walk the walk that God has called us to walk. God commanded the Israelites to go through the land of Esau. We're trying our best to go forward in God. And it just seems like no matter where you go or who you in contact with, it seems like everybody has a crab mentality. Every time I'm trying to go up, somebody is always trying to pull me back down. You know, in this walk, and even in 2012, I have never been through so much discouragement, so many disappointments, so much hurt. A lot of times people don't really understand or really know the things that another person is going through. I try not to wear my life or my feelings on my shoulder. I try to keep a positive attitude. I try to not look at the things that are going on around me, but keep my eyes focused on God. But there's been a lot of hurt and a lot of pain in 2012. And every year, we usually, I don't know if you all do it, but a lot of people make New Year's resolutions. And what I do is, although it's like a New Year's resolution, but what I'm doing is I'm looking back at what happened last year. And I'm saying, I'm not going to repeat the same thing that didn't bring me success in last year. I'm going to do something a little bit different. There are going to be some different things and some different people that I'm going to cut off of my life. Because I found out that they didn't help me to prosper. They had the crab mentality. Every time I tried to go forward, they tried to drag me backward. And I can't do that. I can't keep circling around this mountain. Because God has said, you circled around this mountain long enough. You know, like a lot of times we've done some things, even business ventures, we've gotten into it. And we're trying to make it work. But it's not what God has for you. So if you do what God has you do, even the man had the land. He said, God came and he saw it was not producing. Jesus saw it was not producing. So he was going to, I'm going to pluck this up. said, no, let me just tend to it 1 year. Let me work with you 1 more year. And then if you come back and if nothing is growing on it, then you go it on and tear it down. And a lot of us, a lot of things that we've gotten into, a lot of things that we did with God, just let me work with it 1 more year. Let me try this 1 more time. I'm going to try to fix this 1 more time. I'm going to work with Boo-Boo 1 more year. Let me see if I can get him to change. Let me see if I can continue to pray. But he's just keeping you back. He's holding you back. She's holding you back. So it's a lot of things that we're going to have to cut off for 2013. It's a lot of things that we're going to have to do for 2013 because he says you've circled around this mountain long enough. You've been doing the same old thing long enough and it's not doing nothing for you. Now I'm telling you to go north. When I'm telling you to go forward. I'm telling you to go on in the things that I have for you. Like I said, it's a lot of us that felt like, man, I was just like a dog that was chasing my tail. It's like every time I try to do good, every time I try to do something, it seems like I'm always failing. It seems like I can never get my head above water. But God is saying this year, he's going to take you to that new land. He's going to take you to that new place. He says you've compassed around this mountain long enough. You've done it long enough. And I thank God for the ones who came in here and pressed their way on tonight. A lot of you did not want to come here tonight. A lot of you thought of a million of excuses why you shouldn't be here tonight. But God wanted you to hear this word out tonight. Because I was speaking with that. Experience. They wandered in the wilderness for 40 years and he was with them. But he said not one time did they want for anything. He said not even your sandals on your feet wore out. Everything you wanted I supplied for you. When they were hungry he supplied manna from heaven. When they wanted meat he supplied the quails from out of the skies. When they wanted water he supplied water from a rock. God has supplied a lot of things for us during this year. A lot of times when we didn't think we were going to make it, something always came through. He didn't come when we wanted him to, but he always showed up right on time. And I know he did it for me because I see him show up over and over and over again. There were many people that said this minute you wasn't going to make it. They even said when we first started off in the house, look at them in the house. Look at what they're going to do. God ain't called her to do that. God ain't called no woman, but I met it to them. A woman shall compass a man. There's gonna be some women leaders on this in this earth. There's gonna be some women leaders in this time. Why? Because God just wants somebody that wants a, that has a heart for him. God says in him, we're neither male nor female. We're neither Greek nor Jew. He's not looking at your religion. He's not looking at your gender. He's looking at a person's heart. God looks at the heart of a person. And we know we talked about David. We talked about David on Sunday. David wasn't a perfect man, but the Bible even said from the beginning that David was a man after God's own heart. And a lot of people misjudged you. People misunderstood you. People took your kindness as a weakness and stepped all over you. But God says he's going to turn that situation around. He's going to take that those actions and he's going to make them into beauty. Whatever's been hurting you, whatever had you down, whatever had you bound this year, God is going to release it. Whatever you've been struggling with, whatever you've been asking God to deliver you from, you're about to be delivered on this year. I guarantee you the same thing you saw on last year, you're not going to see in 2013. God told the Israelites, you circled around this mountain long enough. Whatever was holding them back, whatever was keeping them from getting to what they need to be in God. God said, that's enough. That's enough. It's time to move forward. And a lot of times, it just takes us stepping out on faith with some things. Because sometimes we get comfortable in our situation. We get comfortable the way it is because we don't want to take a chance. Because I know if you live your life getting hurt and disappointed a lot, it's a lot of times you don't want to try nothing new. But God said, I dare you to try something new. I dare you to hear the word of God and hear the voice of God and heed to the instructions. Heed into the things that he's speaking in your dreams. And he's sealing his instructions that he's sealing in your heart. I dare you to listen and obey God and see what God is going to do in your life. Isaiah 43:18-19 says, remember not the former things, neither consider the things of old. He say, behold, I will do a new thing. God is about to do a new thing. He said, it's time to move on. So I came tonight to decree and declare that everything in your life is going to come together. Everything that seemed to be falling apart is going to come together. When Ezekiel went to preach to the dry bones, he said, will these bones live? And he told God, he said, God, you know. God knows because he is the author of life. He gives life. He brings death. God is in control of it all. But God told Ezekiel to prophesy to those dry bones. And then as Ezekiel began to speak to those dry bones, something began to happen. Those dry bones began to come together. Then the muscle began to come on the bones. Then before you know it, the skin came on the bones. And before you know it, there was a whole slew of soldiers that were standing up. So what God is saying tonight is things are about to come together in your life. The things that seem dry and dead, the things that seem to have fallen apart, God is going to put them back together. All we need to do is speak to those dry bones. Speak to those dry areas in your life. Speak to those negative things in your life, and God is going to turn it around. All you got to do is just give him a praise. All you got to do is thank him in advance. The songwriter said, praise him in advance. I don't have to wait until it comes. I don't have to wait until I see it. But if I know that God is able, all I have to do is speak it. I can decree a thing, and it shall be so. We've been in this situation long enough. I know that I have. And I'm just going to give a quick testimony. And then I'm going to get ready to pray. And we're going to pray. We're going to bust the heavens wide open. You know, you sit. And you dedicate your life to doing what's right. Towards God. I wasn't always this way. I was at one time pretty selfish. And I don't mean selfish as trying to have things or whatever, but I was kind of off to myself. Because I've been through some things in my life. Starting off as a young child. Sometimes people will say that you're a mistake. When you were born, you were a mistake, but God don't make mistakes. I used to think that, but then I found out that God don't make mistakes.
I just want everybody to just be encouraged.
That no matter what it is that you've been through, no matter what it is you're going through, no matter how hard it may have seemed, there's always a light at the end of the tunnel. And God says that he wants the best for his people. And he wants to give us the best. But all we have to do is be willing and obedient. We can eat the good of the land. Sometimes it's not always easy. Sometimes you go through some things. Sometimes you don't get everything handed to you on a silver platter. It's not just going to be handed to you. Sometimes you got to work for it. Sometimes you got to trust and believe. And the reason why I'm saying all of this is I'm letting you know the things that I've been through in my life. And these are things and situations that will make the average person say, you know what, I give up. I give up on life. I give up on all of this. I'll never do this. I'll never trust God. Everybody will say, where is God? Where was God when all that was happening? Whether the story about the footprints is, while you was going through that, I was carrying you through it. That's why it was only one set of footprints. So I know that it was only by the grace of God that I'm still here today, because there have been some situations that I've been in that I should be dead by now. Selfish. I come here every Sunday. I come every Thursday. I come every time that I can, every opportunity that I can to witness to somebody, to tell them how good God is. And now I'm coming back full circle to why I said all of that. I pray so hard for my family. Pray so hard for my friends and my loved ones. And sometimes I get discouraged. And sometimes I just say, man, I just give up. They want to invite you to parties, invite you to get-togethers, invite you to this, invite you to that. But when you say, come to the house of the Lord, I had one person that told me, you're always inviting us to that church stuff. But I'll never invite you to the church stuff again. Because I wasn't inviting you because I just wanted to see your pretty face. I was inviting you because I was concerned about your soul. And if I don't, when God comes back to say, well, look, I gave you an opportunity to witness to some people while you didn't witness. Now the blood is on your hands. You could have said something to that person, and I've done that. I've done that. So this year, well, pretty much just back up a little bit. I'm going to pray from a distance. I'm not going to wear out my welcome, because a lot of people, when you continue to witness to them, they try to run from you because they don't want to hear that. I don't want to hear about that God stuff. So we've been going around this stuff over and over. We've been going in circles with these loved ones. We've been going in circles with different things and situations and circumstances in our lives. But God says we've gone around it long enough. Yeah. Now we're going to move forward.
That's right.
And I'm telling you, at this time and in this season, when God is moving you forward, you better move forward. If he say let go, you better let go. If he say go forward, go forward. If he say back up and back up, whatever God say, do it, because God is going to move you to something new. He's doing something new in your life. He's going to open some doors in your life. He's going to change some situations in your life. God is about to bring to pass everything that you asked for, everything that you prayed for, everything you believe for. It's about to come to pass. But you got to be ready to move when he said move. Because that is the word for this season. It's time to move on. So I'm going to get ready to pray. I want everybody to stand to your feet.
And I pray.